Hello there, this is the Bible of Soccer, and in this video we want to talk about Portugal, the king of ties, and about how beautiful this world looks like. So I remind you that English is not my first language, either my second language, that I'm recording everything from my cell phone, and I'm here with no guidelines, no teleprompter, no master edition, and I speak like this a little bit slow, so I cannot lose my train of thought. So I remind you also that we're here in St. Petersburg, where the first match for this Confederation Cup 2017 is going to take place. We are here in front of Hermitage Museum, one of the best museums of the world. And in the background, there is some band playing, and I try to do the best for the sound. Okay, so we're going to talk a little bit about Portugal. Okay, Portugal, they have Rui Patricio as a goalkeeper. Okay, he's very good, he has very good reflex, very good elongation, but his best attribute is reading corner kicks. Okay, he's very good at reading corner kicks, and it's a little bit of hard to score him from corner kicks. Okay, now then, here in the defense we have Cedric has a very good tough entrance. Okay, he's a very aggressive player, and he doesn't care of, he's not scared of a yellow card. So he always, I mean, he and Pepe also, they are very aggressive. Okay, he has very good long passes, and he projects himself all the way to the end, and he's very good also with cross passes, as well as the other winger, which is Rafael. He has very good cross passes. Why they need people to do very good cross passes? Because they have here Cristiano Ronaldo, that is very good with the head, and they're gonna need eventually good cross passes to take advantage of this attribute of the best, or the second best, or however you wanna call it, player of the world. Okay, then we have here Pepe. Pepe also, he likes a tough game. He's very aggressive, and he goes to the ball and to the player. Okay, this is very important. He's also not scared of a yellow card. He goes to the ball and to the player, and when he's getting somebody who has not, is not in possession of the ball, he always tries to displace this player from their position. Okay, because he's very aggressive, and he also has long passes as well. Okay, he has long passes as well. Then we have here Fonte, he has very good possession and pressure. He has very good sense of location. This is basically his main attribute, where he's gonna try to read the game. Okay, but when the team is in possession of the ball, one of the important things about Fonte is his short pass. Okay, remember, this is a team, that's why I call it the king of ties, because this is a team that they're gonna try not to lose the game. That's what they do best. Okay, then we have Rafael. Rafael is very good coming from behind, as I mentioned. He can go project himself to the end and try to go like that. He's also very good at defending. Okay, and then we have here William Carvalho. William Carvalho, he has very good aerial game. Okay, but William Carvalho is not the typical defensive midfielder. Okay, in today's football, in today's soccer, the typical defensive midfielder is gonna be the one who make long passes, okay, on target. But this is not the case of Portugal. Why? Because, as I mentioned, they don't want to lose the game, they don't want to compromise the ball. So they don't use the typical modern number five. They use a guy who can make very precise and a little bit in advantage short passes, being his aerial game his best attribute. Okay, this is very important for them. Then they have Joao Mario. He's more defensive than offensive. For this same reason, they're always gonna try to give priority to not lose the match. Then we have here Andre Gomez. He's very good at dribbling. He creates spaces. And the reason why he is positioning here and not here is because he's always gonna try, the coach is gonna try to put him in the same side where Cristiano Ronaldo is located, because he's gonna create a space and he's gonna potential, okay? Potential Cristiano Ronaldo. So that's the reason. Then we have here Andre Silva. Why I have Andre Silva here and not Cristiano Ronaldo? Because Andre Silva is a very good number 9. Okay, he's a very good central striker. So what they're gonna do is, if they put Cristiano Ronaldo here and they move Andre Silva to another position, they're gonna kill a very good player. So they're gonna try to start with Andre Silva here, and they're gonna use either Cristiano Ronaldo in this side or this side. But then it comes the other problem. They have Quaresma, okay? So Quaresma is very good for this team, because Quaresma is basically, his best attribute is that he's very fast and he read the game in a quick thinking way. So this team is not going to try to lose, and they're gonna counterattack. And for this reason, they need Quaresma. So Quaresma, his best position is there and not here. For that reason, he's gonna play there, and Cristiano Ronaldo is gonna start the game here. But later, he can switch or he can move to the back. Okay, but he's gonna start here usually. But this team also, they accommodate to their opposite team. So depending of the players, the best player of the other teams, if they have a good defender in this side, they're gonna try to put Cristiano Ronaldo in the other side, just to take advantage of the worst defenders. So you have to be aware of this. If he's moved from here, it has to be a reason. You have to see also what is going on in the other team. So Cristiano Ronaldo or Messi?
What are you doing?
Cristiano Ronaldo or Messi?
Messi?
Cristiano Ronaldo? Okay, nobody wants to answer. So what's the difference between Messi and Cristiano Ronaldo? So Cristiano, Messi, he used both legs. Messi used both legs, he plays here, and he's the player, he's the fastest player in the world with ball in possession. That's not the case of Cristiano Ronaldo. He's very fast, but he mainly uses only one foot, and he's not as fast as Messi. But what's the difference between Messi and Cristiano Ronaldo? Age, okay? We have seen lately that Messi is not so good as he used to be. But in the case of Cristiano Ronaldo, you don't notice this. Why? Because he has managed very good his career. When he started his career, he used to play there. And then when he started getting older, he moved here, he moves here, and finally, he's there and he has scored a lot of goals. So you still think that Cristiano Ronaldo is the best player of the world, which probably it is, but the reason why you don't notice this difference of age is because he has managed his career to change position in a very smart way, so he can cover whatever he cannot do anymore, okay? So what he has? He has very good dribbling here, where he can avoid players from the opposite team. He's very fast. He has very good game with his head. He has free kick. Rafael and other players, they do free kick as well, but when they play in Portugal, only Cristiano Ronaldo is gonna do the free kick. He also is gonna do the penalty kicks, but if you play against Portugal, most of his penalty kicks are going to go to his left. His left, okay, his left side. Now, how this team plays? They usually defend all of them, including Cristiano Ronaldo. That's why in the Euro Cup, okay, they tie so many matches. They make the game very boring because everybody is gonna defend. So how they attack? They usually attack by the wing, okay, by the side, with a group of four or five players. Group of four or five players. Group of four or five players. Very slow. Okay? Very slow. Group of four. They usually are not going to attack using the midfield. They usually don't going to do that. And the other tactic that they use is the counter-attack. Okay, where Quaresma is a key, is key in this counter-attack when they're gonna go very fast. He can go to the middle, or he can switch with Cristiano Ronaldo and they can do something against the other team. And of course, Cristiano Ronaldo himself, he can change a match anytime he wants, okay? So you have to be aware of this. Now, how you beat Portugal? How you beat them? One way of beating them is corner. But this goalkeeper, as I mentioned, he's very good at corner kicks. So you're gonna have to try to make the corner kick to the second post, or you're gonna have to try to make a short corner kick and then try to do a cross pass to the second post, which is the weakness of this goalkeeper. But anyways, he's very good, so it's not easy to score him, especially from corner kicks. Also, from trying to score him from long distance. Why? Because they usually put a lot of people in defense. They put a lot of people in defense, and then the other team, they have to put also a lot of people there. So one way to score is by kicking from long distance. And what usually happens, even when this goalkeeper, it has very good elongation and reflex, usually what's gonna happen is that the ball is gonna touch somebody, and this goalkeeper is gonna lose his location, because Portugal is gonna try always to bring all their people back to defense, okay? And the other way that you can beat this team, because they put a lot of people behind the ball, so when the opposite team comes with the ball, try to organize an attack, they're gonna put a lot of people behind the ball. So what happened? Nobody's here. Nobody's here. Nobody's here. So if you managed, if you have good player with technique, if you manage to change the game to the other side of the field, you wanna be able to score. Okay, but this, as I mentioned in another videos, is the one of the most hardest things to do in football, is to change the side of the attacking in the last quarter of the field. Okay, so I will advise to go with corner kicks or long distance, but you can try also this. Okay, so this is gonna be everything for this video. If you like it, give me a thumbs up, share it, or you can subscribe. But remember that this is mainly a Spanish speaking YouTube channel. So if you wanna learn Spanish also, you can subscribe. Okay, it says goodbye to you, the Bible of soccer. Thank you very much.